giving a premarital counseling to this couple. Okay, and so they would like to be announced to our church that they're inviting the whole church for their wedding. Okay, and put in your calendars October 8th, and that will be at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Huh? Oh, 3. Okay, so 3 o'clock in the afternoon for their wedding celebration. We'll do it here in our church. Okay, so October 8th. And we are also blessed that the church is being provided by children. And so we are doing a baby dedication today. And we thank the parents, Haley and Carlos, for bringing their children to the Lord. So I'd like to invite them in front together with their baby, Motley Oliver Tress. Motley Oliver Tress. Yeah, this is Tress. My son is Dos because he's the second. Okay, so Tress. Okay, and this baby was born in February 23, 2023, at the University of Colorado Health Memorial Hospital. And I'll ask Natalie to flash in some pictures of this baby as we go on to our, so that's the baby, and he was born 6 pounds 4 ounces, and the length was 18 inches, so we have precious pictures for the parents, the dad, Carlos, and the mom, Haley. So, handsome boy. And today I would like to read a scripture that's found in the book of Deuteronomy. It says, chapter 6, verses 4, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy might. And these words which I command thee shall be in thy heart, and you shall teach them diligently unto your children. You will talk to them, and when you sit in the house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up, and you shall bind them for a sign upon thine hand, and shall be frontlets before thine eyes. So the Lord gives you this admonition today, Carlos and Haley, to bring up your child in the love of Jesus. And the Bible says, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. The Lord has blessed you with a precious baby, Motley Oliver. And I know as parents, you need the Lord's help and guidance. And I'm glad that you're dedicating yourselves for the nurture and admonition of this child. So at this point, I would like also to invite the grandparents to come here in front, and the family, Carla and Alex, you could also come, and Sergio, because it takes a village to build a family. It takes the grandparents and the uncles and the aunts to nurture this child. And so today I give you this charge. Do you, as guardians, as grandparents and parents, do you come confessing your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ in your love, in your lives? And do you come to dedicate yourselves to biblical instruction, to discipline, and for the love of this child?
We do.
Yes. And do you come to dedicate Motley Oliver Tress into the ultimate control of God's will through our Lord Jesus Christ? Amen. Amen. And to our congregation today, you've seen the Tress family dedicating their newest addition to their family, to the Lord. So do you agree to support this family, the parents and the grandparents, by your example through acts of service? Do you agree to reinforce biblical instruction, discipline, and provide an atmosphere of love and acceptance in this church so that this child will grow in the love of Jesus? If you so desire, raise your hand. Amen. This is your church family, and they're willing to support you. At this point, we shall I shall call the elders of the church to come in front that we may lay our hands in prayer for this child. Okay, we have, I think, four elders coming here today. So we will dedicate this child to the Lord. I invite you to bow your heads as we dedicate in prayer. And there is a portion when we lay our hands, okay? Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for blessing us with the Tress family. And today, Lord, we see that they have been blessed by a beautiful child. I do pray that you will be with Motley Oliver, that he may grow to the love and the footsteps of our Lord Jesus Christ. Be with him, Lord, that he may be nurtured, Lord, in the admonition of the Lord. And that he may grow and be absent from any sickness or any infirmity, that he may be healthy and strong, and that this child will be a blessing to this family, a source of joy and inspiration to all of them. And that, Lord, their family will be unitedly serving you. And at this, Lord, juncture, we put our hands to this baby. We bless him in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. May the unction of the Holy Spirit fall upon this child, and that he may grow in Jesus. In his name we pray. Amen. At this point, our elders will give you our gifts, okay, Bible, and then our director of children's ministries, Leda, will welcome you in the children's, will welcome Motley Oliver in the children's division, okay, the cradle role, and that he will give you the Bible story set, okay. And Neff, my wife, will also present to you a gift from the Southwestern Union Conference, some books for nurturing the children. Okay. And then I will give you baby dedication certificates that Motley Oliver Tress, born on February 23, and child of Carlos and Haley, was presented to the Lord on this 16th day of September 2023 at the Odessa English Church, signed by Pastor Razon. Thank you so much, Pastor. Okay, we'll just have a souvenir picture. Special music will be given by Danielle Elnar.
Good morning. Because of who of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Jehovah Jireh,
years ago, I was sitting up here. The two Elner girls and prayer were sitting there, all three dressed in white, just singing up a storm. And I thought, you know, they must be angels. Now we will have our message by Pastor Razon, who needs no introduction. Pastor?
Happy Sabbath, everyone. I'm happy to be here with our church family. And it's nice to see some of you haven't seen for a while. Welcome back, Ibrahim. I know gone for a couple of months. It's nice to see you. And also welcome our Kenyan friends. Yeah, I was in Kenya, so I remember my days in Kenya, so welcome. It's nice to see each and every one of you. And we certainly thank Tim He was our gracious host for the last weekend. We were not here. The men, most of the men were not here. But I was told that there was 76 people here that Sabbath. So that's quite, we were 28. So that's a good turnout. So for the men that are here today, put in your calendar next year, the second weekend after Labor, the first weekend after Labor Day. Okay, so that's usually the second week of September. Put in your calendar if you need a ride. We'll work out with you some type of transportation. So, and thank you, Danielle, for the beautiful song, okay, and also for America, for the children's story. By the way, America, where are you? Happy, happy birthday, okay? Happy birthday to America. And before we go and do our sermon, I would like to just announce that a few weeks ago, our church board approved the names of our new Adventure Club staff. And so I would like our church to know our Adventure Club as they start the new year, the fiscal year. I would like us to support them and to pray for them. So the newly elected Adventure Club leader is none other than Gwen Campbell. Where is Gwen? Please stand, Sister Gwen. Okay. Assistants and staff, counselors, and deputies are Nyla Whitaker. Okay. She'll be helping with the kids. America Muniz. It's America. I know she was here a while ago. Natasha Mulundu. Where's Natasha? Okay. And I'm not reading off there, okay? I'm reading off my list, okay? Adelaida Bursiaga. Okay. Stand. Okay. Arturo and Stephanie Bursiaga. Okay. Ibrahim and Bernice Yosef. Stand. Okay. So these are our new crew. Did I miss anything, Gwen? So everybody's here. Okay. So let's continue to uphold this. Kids, stay standing. I'll pray for you. Okay, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, here are our new Adventure Club staff. I do pray, O Lord, that as the board have chosen them and dedicated them, Lord, I do pray that you will be with them, give them the strength, O Lord, to deal with our children and to nurture these children in the love of Jesus. And give them the patience that leaders need, Lord, as they work with the young people of our church, with the children of our church, and help us to have a vibrant Adventure Club that will serve and work for you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, you may be seated now. So our topic today, the title of our sermon is At-One-Ment. Have you heard about that word before? For sure, I know that you already know by now where the word atonement came from, right? This one meant the title is from the word atonement, okay? And so we will deal with the word atonement for today. So if you have your Bibles, shall open up with the scripture in Romans 5, chapter 12, of chapter 10. And I'm reading from the New International Version. It says, "For if while we were God's enemies, we were reconciled to him through the death of his son, how much more, having been reconciled, shall we be saved through his life?" So atonement, I like to share with you three aspects of this word atonement, okay? And so we gather today to explore this profound and transformative concept of atonement. Atonement is multifaceted, gem in the crown of our faith, because it's encompassing reconciliation, redemption, and reformation or repentance. So on this tree, let us delve into these aspects and illuminate our path toward a more meaningful relationship with God through the concept of atonement. First is reconciliation. Atonement is reconciliation, at-one-ment. The Bible says because of sin, we were separated from God. There's a barrier, there's a gap, okay, between man and God. Remember before, in the Garden of Eden, man used to talk and communicate directly with God, right? Because they were sinless. But when man sinned, Adam and Eve fell into sin, what happened when God was calling them? Where did they go? They went to hid themselves, right? They could not face the perfect, the glory of God. And what is reason? It's because of sin. There was a barrier. There was a gap. So they hid themselves. Now, we know that the Bible starts with Eden lost, the Garden of Eden lost. But it ends chapter 1 to 3 of Genesis, story of how sin came to the world. But the Bible ends with in Revelation 22, and it tells us how Eden or will be restored, right? When we will all again be at one with God, that we could face to face see Him. And it is through our Lord Jesus Christ, right? The second Adam, who reconciled us with God. So when Jesus hang on the cross, it's a symbol that He's bridging man and God, and that we could be reconciled to Him. So in our journey towards atonement, reconciliation stands as the first pillar. By the way, what are we celebrating today? What important event? Aside from the Sabbath, we know it's Sabbath. We read about the Sabbath in our scripture reading. It's a holy day of convocation. It's a day we have to remember to gather assembly. One day, I saw Daniel. Aside from your birthday, Daniel, today, and Ella, what is very important event today? You know? For the Jewish people, it's called the festival of the Rosh Hashanah. Have you heard about it? We're not Jewish. We're Christian. It's celebrated annually by the Jews all over the world. It typically falls on a date in September, and it's 163 days after the first day of Passover. So Rosh Hashanah celebrates the beginning of a new year. It's called the Jewish New Year. Starts from sundown yesterday, Friday, and will continue until tomorrow. Okay, tomorrow, Sunday. So it's the new year in the Jewish calendar and ushers to the 10 days of awe. After today, we count 10 days, culminating in a major fast on the Jewish holiday called what? Yom Kippur. Have you heard about it? Yes. Yom Kippur. What is Yom Kippur? A day of atonement. Okay, to the Jewish. This period is considered one of the most holy time in the Jewish year. Okay, a day of the atonement. So, the theme of Rosh Hashanah, which means the head of the year, and the 10 days of all is repentance. And for 10 days, Jewish people usually focus on their sins for the past year, and then as they contemplate and how they have violated God's laws and injured people, now it's the time for them to confess and to seek and make things right with their fellow men and also with God. And this is an important time of reflection or introspection to consider the consequences of their sins in order to be motivated not to repeat again. And according to tradition, Rosh Hashanah is also called the Day of Judgment, because we've been studying in our prayer meeting. By the way, if you have been here at prayer meeting, you will be blessed. We will not only study the sanctuary, we're studying the judgment, and next week we'll studying the mark of the beast. So, that's important for Adventists to know. We just finished the study on the judgment. So, Rosh Hashanah is also called the Day of Judgment, in which God opens the books of life. He opens the book of death for the year. Now, we've been studying the books here in our prayer meeting. So that's important. That's important to study the books. Do we like our names to be in the book of life? Or there's another book, right? Book of Remembrance. And then there's a third book. What's the book? The book of death. Okay, so in the judgment day, it says that those books will be opened. And so there was a story about a rabbi who during Rosh Hashanah noticed a quarrel between two members of his congregation. And so he wisely asked them, "Do you want your names to be written in the book of life this year?" And they answered, "Of course, Rabbi." So the rabbi smiled at them and said, "Well then, if you like your names to be in the book of life, you must learn how to forgive each other. And for how can God inscribe your names in the book of life when you could not even forgive your fellow human being? So you'll be still quarreling when you go to heaven." So a time of judgment, a time of reconciliation, not only with our fellow men, but also with God. The second point, oh, by the way, Ellen White says in Steps to Christ, page 17, when the soul surrenders itself to Christ, a new power takes possession of the new heart. A change is wrought in which man can never accomplish for himself. So that's the point of atonement, to give us a new heart, because we have been reconciled with God. And once we have reconciled with God, we will have a new heart and serve Him even better. Second purpose of atonement is redemption. Redemption from what? Redemption from sin. All of us are sinners, right? The Bible says, everyone has sinned and have come short of the glory of God. So it says there, all. What's that in Spanish? Todos. Okay, todos. Okay, all. There's nobody exempted then. Okay? Rich or poor, young or old, man or woman, educated, uneducated, nobody's exempted. Jamaicans, Kenyans, Filipinos, Mexicans, you know. What else? Ghanaians, Puerto Ricans, what else? You know, Dominicans, nobody is exempted, okay? Tanzanians, okay? What else do we have here, okay? Huh? Gringos, okay. Texans, okay. Rednecks, oh, everybody, okay? Everybody. Nobody's exempted, it's todos, okay? And we are in equal footing, because at the foot of the cross, the ground is level, right? We are all in equal footing, whoever you are, may be rich or poor, like I said. We need Christ. We need to be reconciled with God. And the second point is, redemption from sin. He redeemed us from our sin. He did not only reconcile us. Atonement is redeeming you and me from sin. Just as the shofar sounds on Rosh Hashanah, there's a guy here by the name of Robert. He brings a shofar, and he blows it on the Sabbath, okay? And, of course, we're not Jewish, and so it has, we don't understand everything. But to the Jewish people, that's a sound of blowing of the horn. It's a call for repentance and a sound that reminds us that redemption is ours. It's also the sound announcing the beginning of a new year. Christ's sacrifice on the cross heralds a new beginning for us. When Jesus died on the cross of Calvary, it's a new beginning for you and me. We could start a clean slate. Through his blood, we are redeemed from the bondage of sin. Imagine a debtor's release. When you are in debt, as if you are, captive. But when our debt is paid, imagine your mortgage is paid in full. That's a happy feeling, right? Imagine your mortgage, not only your mortgage, but all your sins had been paid in full through Christ's sacrifice. Then we are free to start anew in Jesus Christ. And as Ellen White declares in the Desire of Ages, page 25, in dying for sinners, Christ manifested a love that is incomprehensible. We could not comprehend that, how that happened, because Ellen White further says, in that one gift, heaven itself was given in the death of our Lord Jesus Christ. Through his death, this world has been encircled with an atmosphere of grace. And grace is a free gift, and all you could do is accept it. So with that atmosphere of grace, all those who choose to breathe this life-giving atmosphere will grow and live to the men and women that Christ has like us to be. And the last, an atonement, is it is also reformation or repentance. Atonement calls for personal reformation. Atonement calls for our repentance. And since, I already used Rosh Hashanah as a illustration, as this festival day marks a period of reflection and self-improvement, we too should strive to become better, reflecting the image of our Savior. Think of a clay of pot reshaped and molded in the potter's hands. Similarly, that's how God molds and refines us to align with his will. Again, Steps to Christ says, page 57, the closer you come to Jesus, the more faulty you will appear in your own eyes. And as we see our sins, the enormity of what sin has done in our lives, we feel incapable. We feel that we could not do anything. And it's only through Christ's power and coming to him that we could be victorious. So let's come closer to Jesus. So in conclusion, my dear brothers and sisters, again, atonement is a divine gift. It offers us reconciliation, it gives us redemption, and it appeals to us to move to repentance and reformation. And just as the shofar blast calls us to repentance on Rosh Hashanah, let us heed the call of our Savior and commit our lives to a life of consecration. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, and I conclude with this text, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is what? A new creature. A new creature has come. The old is gone, and the new is here. Give us a new heart. May we, all of us, May we have a new creation, walking in the path of atonement with open hearts and resolute and to commit ourselves to God's grace. And this is my prayer.
Let us all rise for the closing hymn.
Settle us in the faith, O Lord, because we already know whom we have believed. And, Lord, we know that Jesus atoned for our sins, and now we have been reconciled. So help us, Lord, to stay firm and strong until the day when he will come in the clouds of glory to redeem his own. In his name we pray. Amen.
We have this prayer.
a blessed Sabbath.